Protea forges in this video will set up the container in the Unity. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, for this project I'm using Unity 6.0.36F1. I also use the Universal 3D template, which generates some URP settings. As you can see, I created some basic directories to organize work and clean up README tutorial assets. To install the container, I will use the git URL and install package via Unity Package Manager. So let's copy line below and then open packages. Go to the manifest.json. Inside it, let's pass git URL. Now go to the Unity, wait for the compilation process to finish. And let's check if the container is in the package folder. And yes. Okay, it's time to check that the package is working properly. Our plan is to create 4 classes and deeply focus on the inversion of control. Hello World service, responsible only for the functionality which can be called anytime. Hello World model, which is responsible for data, keeps references to the objects, etc. Hello World presenter, which is responsible for control flow. Lifetime scope, which allows us to register dependencies to the V container. Okay, so let's create a new script and call it Hello World service. Put it in the tailforge.services namespace. This script will have very basic and simple logic. Just print Hello World message to the editor console. This class will be injected into presenter. It's time to create Hello World model, so our data container. Let's put it in the tailforge.models namespace and add serialized field for the button. Add using and then create getter. That's it. Now let's create the Hello World presenter class. Of course, we need to add read-only member variables. We want to inject dependency, our Hello World service and Hello World model. Let's assign variables in the constructor. Here we want to handle control flow, so let's implement iStartTable and iDisposeable and implement missing methods, start and dispose. Let's create print method, which we will simply call hello-world-service.print. Then, inside start, let's add button onClickListener. Don't forget to remove listener in the dispose method. So let's go to the registration part. We need to create a lifetime scope script. This scope will inject dependencies to the desired objects in the main scene. It will work in a similar way to Zenjek scene context. So let's put it in the tailforge.scopes namespace and derive from lifetime scope. Then write override void configure method with iContainer builder parameter. This builder allows us to register our Hello World service with parameter lifetime.singleton. I will explain other lifetime types in the next videos, but for now you should know that lifetime.singleton means that we can only have one instance of the Hello World service, which is fine for our example. We need to register our Hello World presenter, but, as you remember, I have used iStartTable and iDisposeable interfaces. That's why I need to use the register entry point method. We want to execute function inside Unity Player Loop system, so start, update, onDestroy, etc. That's why we need to use register entry point, so all necessary interfaces like iStartTable, iTCable, iDisposeable and others can be used inside presenter class. Thanks to this solution, we add iStartTable interface to Hello World presenter and implement start method, in which we will add listener to the hello button. Every time we click, our hello world service will execute print to the console. Of course, we can implement other interfaces in the same way. As you can see, here are a lot of interesting entry points. Last thing to do, we need to register Hello World model. To do this, we register it via builder.register component, get component, Hello World model. Of course, let's add require component type of Hello World model attribute. It's time to set up scripts inside the Unity editor. Wait for the compilation process to finish. Let's add simple UI button. Then create empty game object, Hello World. Drag and drop button into it. Then attach script, Hello World lifetime scope. Thanks to require component, Hello World model is automatically added. So let's drag and drop reference to the button. Okay, look like we have everything prepared, so let's play and click button. Excellent, everything works as expected. I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all mods, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.